Good evening, this is BelGeode and we are back with some Skyrim. Yeah, I know it's been a little bit of a while since you've seen me, but I decided I wanted to get back into the adventure and do some of the off-the-wall stuff that you haven't seen before. Or maybe you have seen before. Alright, so we are back with Ghita Shrike, and of course her sisters are somewhere around here gallivanting, and good old Belenos Geode, her trusty boyfriend. As you can see, I got them some new armor. If you recall in my last series, I was looking for new armor for them because the Terra armors are really cool, however, not entirely what I need. So, we are going to be doing the Gauldur legend here. The Gauldur legend, as you can read, long ago, Archmage Gauldur was murdered and his three sons hunted down by King Harald's personal battle mage. The entire incident was covered up, their names struck from every record, but the legend survived. Okay, so we are going to be going back to the Morthal area, to Folgunthur, over by Morthal. And we're going to start this particular quest series and see if we can get it done. And we might actually tie it into some of the other quests that people have actually been asking me to do. Now, please bear in mind that I do record this stuff ahead of time, so I may not always be able to incorporate everything that you need, but I'm going to try my best. Alright, so it's just Bel and I, Bel and Ghita, that is, and we are going to go ahead and head out. Oh great, it's snowing. Well, we might as well wait until the weather clears a little bit, which should be about an hour. I got some new mods added in there, including a realistic needs mod. As you can see, it says rested. That will change over time, so I'll fill you in when that happens. Okay, it is about a couple of hours later, and the sun is finally up. As you can see, the Deva Vesa is over there. We will not be taking that, because that is still giving me script issues. So, Mr. Bel, let's go. So let me just kind of catch you up on what's been going on. Ghita is now level 29. I actually got a few levels in between the last series that I ran, and now, partly because I did a lot of crafting and so on and so forth, and I get a lot of XP for crafting. So this armor that you're seeing now, that is something that I crafted. I crafted one for Bel and one for Ghita, so that way they can be like a matching couple. You know, it's cute like that. And I crafted some other miscellaneous stuff, including one thing that I will be showing off maybe in this episode, maybe in the next episode, which is a camping kit. I actually downloaded a camping kit that is really freaking awesome, so I hope to show that off for you there. Alright, let's get to running. Our plan is we're going to run to Whiterun and then take the carriage. I also got a mod for the carriages as well, so you can actually see both Bel and Ghita in the carriage. There are some slight issues with it, so you won't be seeing like an entire trip of us sitting in the back of a carriage on the way to Morthal. I'll be doing a little bit of the magic editing there. But be that as it may, at least it adds a little bit more immersion. And that was the idea behind my downloading all the various mods over the last few days here, was to get a bit more immersion. So I've got the realistic needs thing. Food in my inventory will now spoil if it sits there too long. Raw food will make you sick if you eat it. And every few hours you definitely have to eat and drink. You can get drunk, so I may actually show Ghita getting drunk and falling over at some point in time. It's really, really neat. I love stuff like that because it definitely adds to the immersion and the storytelling that, you know, I'm trying to get across in these particular videos here. So yeah, we got the realistic needs. What else did I get? I'm trying to think here. The camping kit, of course, I got. There were a few minor stuff that I added in there that it's escaping me right now. But as usual, if you're used to watching my Skyrim videos by now, you'll know that I'll have a list of mods underneath in the description area so that you can find them if you decide you want to get them on the Nexus or the Steam Workshop. I'd say about 99% of the mods that I get them off the Nexus simply because that's just like the biggest clearinghouse for mods. But there are a few select mods that I only get from Steam Workshop, such as Multi-Followers Lite, which is what allows me to have multiple followers coming with me at the same time. I do have AFT, which is the Advanced Follower Tweaks, but I don't use that to gain more followers. I use that to make tweaks to them, like giving them spells, fine-tuning their outfits, their combat skills, and so on and so forth. So yeah, cool stuff, cool stuff. Alright, what else has been going on here? Oh, one cool thing that I got. Well, we'll see how cool it is in the long run. I got this thing called Follower Commentary Overhaul. Because you know how your followers really don't talk to you unless, of course, you talk to them. And occasionally they might announce, oh, look, a cave. I wonder what's inside or something like that. Well, there's thousands and thousands of lines that were written for all the various voices in Skyrim. This thing will actually take a lot of those voices and contextually put them into your followers' mouths. So we're probably going to be hearing from Bel during the course of this thing here. And here we are back in the ghetto of Riverwood. Yeah, I'm just going to keep going right through. I have no business in this town. I don't know why I don't like Riverwood. It's just, it rubs me the wrong way. Alright, now that we're out of here, I'm thinking we're not going to take the road all the way to Whiterun. Most likely we're going to go up the hill and then just back down the other side. We'll take the off-road travel path here. So that should be cool. So yeah, follower commentary overhaul. You'll be hearing from Bel at some point in time. Touring carriages is one that I was talking about earlier, where the carriages, you'll actually see your companions getting on the carriage with you, and the carriage will actually move, but there's some movement issues with it, so I won't be using that one extensively either. But since, as part of this series, I've decided to use the carriage as an acceptable mode of transportation instead of quick travel, you know, you'll be seeing that as well. I also changed the movement speed. You will notice that Ghita is not running nearly as fast as she did before, but by the same token, her walk speed is a little bit faster than normal, and her sneaking speed is a little bit slower than normal. So that is a mod called Realistic Humanoid Movement Speed. Really cool stuff. I don't think I need another tweak when it comes to movement speed. It also keeps the NPCs matched at your speed as well, too, so I don't have to be waiting for hours for Bel and some of the other companions to catch up with me. Another really cool one that I found was bathing in Skyrim, which means there may be nudity at some point in time, but I'll try to keep it as tasteful as possible. Your character can get dirty. You have to make soaps. You can cook soaps at the cooking pots. And for each different type of soap that you use, you will get various buffs once you're clean. You also get debuffs if you're not clean. So it's kind of similar to the whole realistic needs thing, where if you don't eat, you don't drink, you know, you can potentially fall over dead, and you can also hurt yourself as far as your abilities, your recharge, and so on. Alright, so I think I've yakked enough. Here we are at Whiterun, and let me go talk to my good buddy over here and see if I can scam us a ride to Morthal. Good morning. What's up, sir?
Need a ride?
Yes, I would like to hire your carriage.
Where do you want to go?
We're going to Morthal today.
Sit back and enjoy the ride.
There we go. You'll notice it's a little bit different. Your character no longer goes to the back of the carriage and climbs in. You just automatically appear in there. And there we go. I think the way that this mod worked is they took like the opening scene and just kind of modified it a little bit so that you and your companions are in the back. But either way, we are off. So next stop, Morthal.
I used to be an adventurer like you. And I took an arrow in the knee.
Well, figures we might as well get that the hell out of the way from the start. And yeah, that carriage ride was a little bit rougher than I would have thought. So, yeah, we won't be doing that anytime soon. Okay, and the only downside is it still shows you with your arms crossed. You just jump to stop the animation there. Mr. Bel, really love that hat. Alright, let's go ahead and get going. Let me see. We are in Morthal now. We need to go there to just outside of Folgunthur. We're not going to fast travel, but we are going to place the marker. And let's get out of this crazy-ass town. Okay, it is right that way. Okay, so that's pretty short distance here. And those kids, we'll just avoid them at all costs here. I don't plan on getting waylaid by a whole bunch of kids asking me all kinds of ridiculous questions here. Have you seen my mom? No. Nor do I intend to look for her. Why don't you go look for her? Here there's some vampires over there that's calling you. Alright, here's the little house that we went to in the last series. We still have the key for that, so if we wanted to, we could still crash here from time to time. instead of like going to the inn or something like that. I don't even remember if Morthal even has an inn. That's how often I come to this damn place. Okay, so we are going to head in this direction. Oh yeah, so I started to tell you a little bit about the armors. It's ironic, the last time that I was in this very neck of the woods, I was talking about armors, and I was talking about, you know, how much I love the Terra armors. Oh crap, there's a crab. Hold that thought. There we go, seafood is served, alright. Every time I start a subject, I gotta stop because something's trying to kill me. Love it. Come on, Bel, let's go.
My pa used to say, there ain't no use worrying about the things you can't change.
That was good with that lightning back there, by the way. That was really good. I like that. Ooh. Synergy skill. Nice. Nice. Alright, actually, I was in this exact location the last time I was talking about armors. Even though I do like the cheesecake factor, you know, the armors that show off the big boobs and the butt and all of that kind of stuff. I mean, hell, I'm a guy. I'm a guy who happens to like big girls, so... yeah, that kind of stuff, I do enjoy that, but I realize it can get a little bit old after a while, so that's why I downloaded something called Immersive Armors.
Oh, for the love of Mara, what now?
And there's a supplement to it called Immersive Armors for CBBE, since that's the body style that I use. So I haven't discovered, like, all of the various armors, but one thing that we will notice is as we travel, you will find various types of armor as loot that you've never seen before. You can equip it, and you can craft it, and so on and so forth. So, just like this armor that both Ghita and Bel are wearing right now, there's some really kick-ass looking armor that's going to be showing up throughout the course of her adventure. This, I believe, is the campsite. So, what are we looking for here? Oh, there's a book. Daynas Valen's Journal. Okay, I'll bite. Cover my back, Bel. Let's see, how long has it been since I first heard the Gauldur legend? 80 years? 100? I can think of nothing else now. My goal is at hand. Okay, so there's an ivory claw involved in this. 3 days of non-stop riding. Okay, the other passengers are becoming suspicious. Returning from dinner, I caught one group rooting around in my quarters. Almost found the claw. Had the captain not intervened, I would have flayed him alive. Yeah, right, this guy sounds like an asshole. Let's see. 3 weeks to solitude. Okay. Well, so far it sounds like this guy's been keeping a pretty good diary here. With the Bruton's companions in tow, I led our band across the marsh to Folgunthur. Okay, so they're inside, basically, is what I'm getting out of this here. And it looks like he is really close to getting that first amulet. Cool beans. Alright. So, that should progress our story along a little bit, and I think it is time to go inside of Folgunthur. We'll keep this camp handy. We may have to come back here and use it as our own resting spot. And I don't think I'm too hungry, so I don't think I need to eat anything just yet. Yeah, I think we're pretty much good to go. Alright, Bel, let's head out of here. I will meet you at Folgunthur, which is... conveniently, right over here. Provided I can get over this rock. There we go. I love doing the dungeons in here, and by the way, remember we were talking about the bathing in Skyrim? When you go through a dungeon, you get considerably dirtier than just walking through the wilderness or walking through a city. Ooh! And here's my favorite part of dungeons. Burial urns! Yes! All the gold! I need all the gold. Take all of your soul gems. I'm not going to take any embalming tools, though. Leave that alone. Linen wraps I also need, because I can make some of the Terra dresses with that, and I've actually started to use the Terra armor as more, like, fashionable armor. I know it's not lore-friendly, but then I'm not really going for lore-friendly. I just go for what looks good to me. Where the hell is Bel? I thought he was behind me. Bel, where the hell are you? What in the... Bel, this is going to be an interesting journey. I should have taken Tanya. Bel, hurry up. We ain't got all day, man. Damn. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I've got Adventurers Assemble. I can just pull Bel to me. There we go.
Look at those ruins. I think there's gold.
Yeah, of course there's gold. What kind of question is that? Okay, so yeah, you're going to be hearing a lot from him. Hope he doesn't get too annoying. For that matter, I hope I don't get too annoying. You will let me know if I'm getting too annoying. Alright. So here we are. Well, I guess no time like the present, so let's go ahead and get in there. Now remember, the sneaking speed is going to be a little bit slower. When I crouch down, you will see. It'll be a noticeable difference. And it says I'm thirsty. Okay, so that's our first indication from Realistic Needs. Bel, no sitting down on a job, buddy. We gotta go, man. We gotta go. And first things first, I got a burial urn over here. I don't think there's anything else up here, but there are a bunch of corpses down there that look like they can be looted. Oh, some of them are draugrs. Okay, so we're in for that as well. I did get the perk Light Feet, so I will not be setting off any traps, which is a damn good thing, let me tell you, because I really hate the freaking traps in places like this. But we're going to try and see if we can stay alive as long as we possibly can here. I'm going to go ahead and just loot everything off of these draugrs. We'll sort it out later. Okay, looting is done, so I'm going to continue heading down here. And I already see one of those things that you put the dragon claws in, the keystone or whatever they call it. Yeah, keyhole. But we don't have the dragon claw for this. It says we need the ivory claw, which of course is in here, based on that dude's journal. Oh, doesn't look like these people got through the first floor. An adventurer. Well, let's take what you got here. I am going to take her armor, so she is going to go naked, but we're going to do it tastefully this time. And thank you. Okay. I think that was good. I think that was good. Alright, we'll take all of you guys, because I know you guys don't go naked. And let's see, what do we got here? Eagle, snake, whale. Okay, so whale. Wait. Whale, snake, eagle, and then I know there's snake on this side. Do I need to punch that in, or is it already set? Let me see here. There's another keyhole over there, so there's some kind of room back there. Ooh, burial urn. Nice. There's another draugr. Oh, I'll take all of that. Alright, so we got snake, we got eagle on this side, and then we've got whale and snake on the other side, which I believe is what they actually should be. Okay, so they solved this puzzle ahead of time. I don't need embalming tools. What do we have on this side? Yeah, all of those are already correct, according to what I'm seeing. Ooh! Magicka potion. Yes! I'm also going to incorporate Alianis' quest to learn more magic into this. I haven't decided how I'm going to do it, but I may actually debut alternate actors, which I've been meaning to show you guys, because I think it is really cool. It allows you to play as another character that you have, or any character in Skyrim, for that matter. But I'm going to be using it for my sisters and Bel. Alright, I don't want any of that stuff, because it's stale, as you can see. So we are going to go this way. There's another one of those trap thingies. I'm going to go around it, even though I know I'm not going to set it off, because of the Lightfoot perk. But yeah. Oh! And we got company. Boink! Come on, one more. There we go. You may notice I got some more steel arrows. I pretty much went around to a lot of the shops and bought some. I am looking for a mod that will allow me to craft it without me needing to have Dawn Guard, because I do not have Dawn Guard anymore. Don't ask me, long story. Actually, I think I told the story before. But yeah, I would like the ability to craft my own arrows. I think that would make my life a hell of a lot easier. Alright, so moving forward. I think I see some oil on the ground there. Might have to use my fire skill and set that alight. What the hell was that? Oh, crap. It locked Bel out. Did I do that, man? Sorry. Oh, and we've got more company. Alright, here we go. For the win. Let's see how my archery skills have fared. Okay. My practice on goats have been paying off. Yes! 2 for 2. Can we go 3 for 3? We sure can! I know there's more around here because the eye is still partly open. Oh, there they are, there they are. Okay, so we got 2 of you suckers there. You are on the move, so we're going to lead you. There we go. And this last one is going a little too fast for me to catch. Hopefully Bel will get him. Come on, Bel. Use some of that unlimited power stuff. There we go. That's teamwork. Making the dream work, as always. Okay. So now we can loot these suckers. I kind of like the slower sneaking movement. I know for someone who's just watching this, it might seem like, oh my god, it's going to take him 5 years to get to the other side of the room. But I think it's actually pretty decent. Plus, he can swap out between walking and running. And they did make a pretty dramatic difference there. It feels more realistic to me, you know? And that's the whole thing that I'm going for in this. It's another dead adventurer, so we're going to make you naked. It's dark over here, so you shouldn't be able to see anything. Alright, there we go. And that is definitely oil, so I will probably be setting that on fire because I kind of like doing that. At least to clear it out of my way so that I don't accidentally get set on fire later. Okay, let's switch that around. It's under spells. There we go. Okay, by default I've got flames and healing. I also gave Bel the ability to heal himself. He does not currently have the ability to heal me, but we'll work on that once we get to Alley. Alright, so there we go. Set naked dude on fire. Loot the rest of these guys over here. What you got for me, Draugr? Got anything good? Eh. We'll set this place on fire, just in case there's any more hiding out around here. I keep hearing noises here. I'm going to be paranoid this entire time in here. Okay, and we will collect from you. Thank you so much. I also got another ranger perk that allows me to retrieve more arrows. It's one that I've wanted, but I didn't have it before. What is this? Oh, this is one of the new armor pieces. Cool. So yeah, we're just going to find those lying around. And I might want to see what that looks like on Ghita, because she does not have a helmet. And even though I absolutely love her red dreads, let's take a look and see what this makes her look like. It's probably going to look stupid, but, you know, whatever. Alright, where was it? There it is. Redguard Knight Light Coif. Holy crap, she looks like Attila the Hun. Or something like that.
The ancient Nords were a savage people, but they built some remarkable crypts and temples.
Eh, we'll keep it on her. It looks stupid, but we'll keep it on her for a little while until we find something else. Because, I mean, it's armor. Armor is armor. Alright, so on that note, we are going to stop right here, and then we'll pick up the rest of this dungeon in episode 2. So as always, thank you for watching. If you've been enjoying the series, please feel free to like, and don't forget to comment, and share the hell out of it. And I will talk to you all really, really, really soon. Ciao!